today I prepared a special message. I'm going to share a little spiritual soul food with you on call. Jesus is the reason for this season. Jesus is the reason for every season. And I'm going to have a few of you call in. So start thinking about what you like to share when you get ready to call in is why Jesus is the reason for this season. You know, we always say that, but we want to know what you feel that why Jesus is the reason for this season. And I believe we also, before I start that, we have a special guest on the line, which is, what is her name? We have a special guest on the line, which is Al's mom. He's my videographer, and she's holding on the line. And I believe she wants to share a special few thoughts today. Is that right, Al? What's her name? Okay, Dorothy. She's on the line. Sister Diane, is Sister Dorothy ready to come on the line? Okay, we're going to put her on. This is Al Christopher's mom. Before I get started, I want to give her a little bit because she just called in before my program started, and she wanted to share some sentiments and words of encouragement. And so before she hangs up, before I get started here in covering all this, that may take a few minutes. We don't want her holding that long. So let's have Miss Dorothy come on the line right quick. All right, Miss Dorothy, are you there?
Yes, I am.
Okay, thank you. Thank you so much, Miss Dorothy, for being on the line this morning. And you wanted to share a few thoughts with us today, or you had a few comments you wanted to share today?
Well, the best thoughts that come to mind to me every day is do the best I can do with what I have to do with. And every day is a challenge.
Yes.
And we're being challenged because the good Lord knows that we can handle it.
All righty.
And I, having had polio, when I was only 4 years old, and recovering all except for being able to use my left arm, everybody would say, "Oh, what a shame, a disability or a handicap."
Okay.
To me, I have not ever looked at it as either one of those. Those are challenges. What I have are challenges. And it's not what I've lost, it's what I have.
All right.
And which to do with. And that is, to me, that is the way the good Lord wanted us to see life. Not cry about the losses. Say thank you for what you have left me to do with.
Oh, Miss Dorothy, I love that, because what you're basically just saying in the way that it's supposed to be is we don't look at our disability, whatever it is hindering us, as saying we have to write you off. You are not 100% together. You're missing something. Like a lot of people do, is they just look at that one little thing and say, you know, you're not 100% made the way, you know, I am. So, I mean, I got it all and you're missing something. And people will tend to look down on others just for that reason, to say that, you know, you didn't come here put together good. So, you know, something didn't get put together in a little pot for you and your little mold. So I'm the one that's completely whole. So you're incomplete. And so what you're actually saying there is that what our audience need to hear today is that no matter what's going on, no matter what it looks like, God loves you. He has no respecter of a person or people, that he loves us all in spite of our disabilities, regard of our race, our creed, our color, our origin. He loves us all no matter what. He loves you if you're over there in Africa. He loves you if you're in Afghanistan. He loves you no matter where you live. And he actually designed with purpose to place you in these areas that you were born. And I can
correct.
That's correct. That's right. And I can.
To me, I have always said it was a gift that God gave me to, you know, having the polio. Because he knew I was capable of doing anything I made up my mind to do.
Yes.
And to me, it's been a gift because I have tried to do and have done almost everything. Anybody with two hands, some people say they can't do it and they have all their faculties. The only problem is, or I should say situation is, between myself and someone who thinks in a negative tone, is that, is your glass half full or half empty?
All right,
and
now.
My glass is always three quarters full.
Okay. Now, she went there, Sister Diane. Okay. Is your glass half full or half empty? Okay. Well, Sister Dorothy, you have said a word today regarding that, because we do want our glass to be full. But sometimes, you know, it you get up a little bit and it's slow filling it up at that point. But through the rest of the day, we get it all filled to the brim and running over.
Well, God gave us a brain to think with. And it's up to us to decide in the morning when we get up whether we're going to have a good day or a bad day. And we make that good. If we wait for somebody else to make us happy or make it good, we're not going to have it. And, you know, it's attitude. It's a person's attitude about things that can turn everything around. It's been a proven fact, educationally and through education and medical research, that 95% of the people who are successful at doing what they do in their life is because of a 95% attitude that they can.
Exactly. Well, Ms. Dorothy, what I'm going to do is I'm going to read a little information about my topic today. Jesus is the reason for every season. And I want you just to share a thought with us why you feel that Jesus is the reason for this season and every season. So just listen for a moment as I read this, and then we're going to move on. It says here, at this time of year, there is always controversy, and God knows it is. It's like, we know how to spell Christmas, and some people have the nerve to write Christmas with an X-MAS. Now, does that make any sense, Sister Diane? Christmas, does an X say Christmas? That doesn't say anything. So it seems that some folks are offended when Christmas displays are religious in nature. People get upset about that, seeing the baby Jesus, the stables, the little mangers, or whatever they set up on the yard. Sometimes it seems that things thought of as Christian symbols are found particular offensive by some people. Not all, just some people. That is a sad commentary on a nation which was founded on basic Judaism and Christian principles, as well as a healthy concern for freedom of speech and expression and of religion. Now, many are saddened in this country of these kinds of attacks, which are based on anti-Christian sentiments. Now, for example, his word tells me that it is honorable to spend time in contemplation of his holy word every day. A lot of us do that, and some of us don't. And his word tells us that being his disciples involves daily service and sacrifice. And he was saying to them all, if anyone wishes to come after me, he must deny himself and take up his cross daily and follow me. And also it tells us that every day we ought to be reminding others of the Lord and encouraging them to live faithfully, but encourage one another day after day as long as it is still called today, so that none of you will be hardened by the deceitfulness of sin. The gospel is to be shared every day from the first day we come to believe it until the present, in view of your participation in the gospel from the first day until now. So God actually is telling us every day it's a day to serve the Lord. It's a day to give honor and to God. It's a day to know that Jesus Christ, that we've accepted Jesus Christ into our life, and we don't want to be caught dead without Jesus in our life. Because I don't want to think about what would happen, but if you did die today, someone out there today died and did not know Christ. So we want to just accept him into our life, because that's the precious gift of salvation. So what I'm just going to ask you this before I let you get off the line. Why do you feel that Jesus is the reason for this season and every season?
Why do I feel what?
That Jesus is the reason for the season.
I really, you know, it's difficult for me to answer that in just a few words.
Okay.
I have this thing in my mind. And there's only one letter that makes the difference between bitter and better. If you change the I to E, it's better.
All right.
It's how you see things. And God is out there not to destroy us or to create bad things. And it's man's attitude, how they take it or how they cope with it.
All right.
And it's up to each one of us to remember we're never alone. We always have God with us.
That's right.
Every day. And when we forget that and we think we're all alone, we put ourselves on that island of loneliness.
Mm-hmm.
So you got to learn to love yourself a lot in spite of everything else and keep on trucking, doing the best you can do.
Well, thank you, Sister Dorothy. Be blessed. We're going to continue with the program. Now, you have a blessed day in the Lord, okay?
You too, and thank you ever so much for all you have done and given.
Thank you.
All right.
Bye-bye. The Matters of the Heart is going to be sponsoring a Christmas event called Toys for Tots. It's for families who have children, small children, or even children that's 10, 12, 14, whatever, that they just want to bless with a Christmas gift. Because no matter if we know Jesus is the reason for the season, still in this time of season, we are accustomed to giving gifts to our children, to our family, and to our friends, and to those of our loved ones. And so it's just that season. If you haven't given a gift to anyone this year for any other reason, just to say I love you, well, some people exchange gifts during the month of December, as we call them Christmas gifts. So we're hosting a program on December the 15th, 2012, at Glad Tidings Assembly of God. And that address is 4200 17th Avenue North. This anointed Christmas event will start at 11 o'clock a.m. We want to invite each and every one of you to attend the event and just come out and share with us as we give God the honor, praise, and glory, because Jesus is the reason for this season and for every season. And from the depths of my heart, as the radio host that will be hosting this event and the president of Matters of the Heart, I am just asking from the depths of my heart that any of you listening today will give me a call today and let me know that you want to be a part of it too. Either if you want to be on the program to share a special gift or talent that you have, or if you are just led by the Spirit of the Living God to bless us with some toys for these children. You can bless us with some toys for children from 1 to 10 years old. You can get us a gift card to give to the family, or you can buy some clothing. But I have several families already signed up. So what I actually need is just someone to give us a call to bless us with toys and clothing and gift cards, or you can make a monetary donation. You can give me a call at 727-488-8818. Give me a call today at 727-488-8818 to let me know what you'd like to donate to help us with these families that we already have on our list that we want to bless with some Christmas joy. Because 'tis the season to be jolly, and it is a time for us to just bless those that we can be a blessing to. Because if God has blessed you today and you're listening to this program, you are truly blessed of the Lord. Again, I told you the program is on December the 15th, 2012, at Glad Tidings Assembly of God, 4200 17th Avenue North. And we just welcome you to attend this event. Call us if you like to, as I stated, be on the program, share a gift, whether you sing, play a musical instrument, whether you do mind ministry, whatever your gifting and talent, poetry, spoken word, all that good stuff. We'd like to have you a part of that program because we are looking for some good anointed entertainment to be a part of this Christmas event, Toys for Tot. And we will have the families there, children there, and just want you to come out and be a part of it. Now, just listen to this for a moment. The preeminence of Christ is often ignored by a fallen world. I do suppose that more render at least lip service to his glory and majesty at this time of the year. I'm also sure that some very sincere praise is offered during this season as well. But Jesus has not requested that we devote such a season to honoring his birth. We just decided to do this. He didn't ask us to do this. I do not know why he didn't, but I do trust him to have revealed unto his apostles all truth, and that in the scripture we find a completely adequate guide to being faithful disciples all year long, not just in the month of December, all year long. But his word says absolutely nothing about a specific and a special religious Christmas observance, which we can find in the word of God stated in John, the 14th chapter, the 26th verse. We're the ones, we're the ones that decide that we're going to just have a special religious holiday to observe his birthday. But in the meantime, like I say, it's just a reminder of us just to have that love and just have that spirit of giving and just family getting together and just having a good time, just giving on and just going back through the very beginning of when Christ was born in his humble beginnings and in that little stable with his mother, Mary, and his father, Joseph. And just coming to the world, that gift that God sent to the world. We just thank God for that. You be blessed. Now, we're going to be coming back forth again next Saturday from 1 to 1:30 with another radio broadcast ministry of Matters of the Heart. Be blessed and have a God-filled day until we're able to come again before you on Praise 1590 AM WRXB. Be blessed.